So much NFL history has come from within the walls of Soldier Field here in Chicago. And we're happy to return to it once again in its final chapters as an NFL stadium. Welcome to another entertaining matchup, folks. Kate Scott, Brock Heward on the call in this one. And Brock, got a couple of running backs down on the field who can really take over their offenses when they get in the groove.
And I think that's going to be the ultimate goal of both of these offenses, right? I mean, there's just no confusion about it. They want to get their bell cow in that groove and get them going. Find that rhythm where they're ripping off chunk yardage run after run and then just keep on feeding that beast. In a game like this, whichever offense can get that rhythm and run game going first is likely going to be your winner.
Ready to get this game started, here's Eddie Pinheiro. And we're underway from Soldier Field. Bayless Jones now on the return. He stopped on the return at the 27. So out come the Bears, ready for their first possession. And leading them out to the number one overall pick in this year's draft out of USC, a player with immense promise, Caleb Williams.
Caleb was one of the most hyped prospects ever out of college football, and I'm not speaking out of turn or any hyperbole there. That's why he was the number one pick. And you put on his highlight reel, Kate, you could put that highlight reel against anybody the last 50 years. The way that he creates and extends plays, the ways that he can run and still sling it totally off platform and off balance all over the field. He also does it with a flair, an eccentricity that is unique and really not common coming into the league as well. A superstar in the making.
Couldn't connect on first, it's second down. Now here's DeAndre Swift on the ground. And he got it real close, but stopped just about a yard or so shy of that first down.
Some backs are easier to tackle than others. Some, well, they just choose violence. They look for those opportunities to bust through tackles and keep those legs pumping.
Third and a lone yard coming up. Off the play fake, Williams. And even on third down, he sees no choice other than to get rid of it. Not the play they wanted. It's going to be fourth down.
There was almost no resistance offered against a rush that came off the line ready to maul anything in sight. It was all the QB could do to get rid of that before he gets absolutely clobbered.
On fourth down, it's Torrey Taylor on for the Bears to punt this away. And they bring him down to put a stop to that return. So now out comes the Panther offense for its initial drive of the game. Bringing him out is a man who made his debut over a decade and tens of thousands of yards ago. It's Andy Dalton.
And it doesn't take him long to get into a groove. Find that comfortable zone where everything is working for him, where the game slows down. And that's when he becomes most dangerous. Kate, he told us this week he wants to settle into that really early in the game. If that happens, that's bad news for this defense.
Drive starts out with a first and 10. They'll motion Johnson right. To throw, here's Dalton. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he's able to get it to the 21 as he goes down.
Well, that's a pretty similar result to a first down run play. Moves it forward. Keeps you on schedule and makes second and third down a whole lot easier to manage.
Second down now, seven to go. From the 21. The Bears close it in and they'll get him. And that pushes him back, third down coming up.
All right, first sack on the board on the first drive as a defense. And now, well, now we let the chess match begin. The adjustments begin because we know pressure leads to sacks. And sacks in this league often leads to wins.
Yeah. And the Bears bring in an extra defensive back for this third down. Throwing with a blitz on the way. It's tipped away and it's going to hit the ground incomplete. Defender winning that rep. That brings up fourth down.
Well, Kate, that wasn't a fast enough break for the interception, but it was good enough and a good enough break to break on the ball, get a finger on it, and force the incompletion.
So on fourth down now, the Panthers calling an all-pro several times over. It's Johnny Hecker for the punt. And they bring him down to put a stop to that return. That punt finishes as a 60-yard effort. And it's going to be Bears football. They'll head up first and 10 from the 42. Out of the gun, here's Williams. An alert play defensively there. He got a hand on it to tip it away, and that makes it second down.
You know, as a QB, I'm going to note that in the back of my head. That was a heck of a break. Knocks the ball away. DBs like that, they tend to, once they get one hand on the ball, have a pretty good bead on you and can get two hands on it the next time.
Williams thrown again here on second down. This one is tipped away and incomplete. Good positioning to make a play on it. That forces third down.
I mean, you can see it right there. The trajectory of the ball changed as it was in flight. You know, on shorter throws, receivers, they could focus, they can adjust quickly. But on a long distance throw like that, a tip, well, it really alters the course of the ball and makes it so tough to make an adjustment in time.
Third down, here's Williams. No better luck than the last play, Brock, as he just has to get rid of it.
So many coaches love third downs, and they practice them so much, Kate. Why? Because they're the money down in the NFL. Whether it's a close game or already out of hand, coaches know, got to execute and convert on these third downs.
Chicago brings out the punting unit. Went for 48 with his first kick, and this one looks even better. That hits at the 9, but nobody around to grab it. It carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Now for the second time, we take a look at this Panther offense. And they haven't gotten their legs under them on offense just yet, Brock. Three plays and a punt on their opening drive. They're out and set, first and 10. Dalton. And he won't escape. The Bears take him down. And the big play drives them backwards. Second down coming up.
Sometimes I wish everybody could feel what that feels like. When you're a QB and you just feel the air in the pocket getting sucked out and you know there's no escape, it can be just one heck of a deflating feeling. Not for that defense who puts a sack on the board.
Offense to the line for second down. Trying again, following the sack. Tremble with the grab. And he rips off good yardage, but it will not move the chains.
You know, Kate, over the years, I have heard defensive coordinators say, hey, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. You got to earn the right for me to call blitzes. And when you call a blitz and you don't get home and you don't hit the quarterback, you've earned nothing.
Throwing now, third and 2. It's tipped away and it's going to hit the ground incomplete. Defender winning that rep. That brings up fourth down.
Not an open passing lane to be found anywhere. He took what he thought was the best one available, and they still managed to tip the ball away.
Panthers getting everyone set for the punt. Back deep for the Bears is DeAndre Carter. His first effort went 47 yards. Brock looks to have a little more into this one. His work begins at the 31. And they bring him down to put a stop to that return. It's a 54-yard punt that time. And they'll get ready to go on offense. Oh, Here's first and 10 from the 34. Here's Swift to start the drive. And he can only manage 1 yard. The defenders were at the ready to bring him down.
I think one thing you learn, Kate, when you transition from college to the NFL, not every run is going to be a big play. Some of them, well, they're just destined to end in a minimal gain, and some of them will set up that critical play action for later.
They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9. Oh, they're going to run the option to the short side. And he won't salvage that. It's a loss on the play.
It's easy for me to say up here in the friendly confines of the booth, Kate, but that was not the right read. And you hate seeing him absorb yet another hit at the end of the play. You never want him taking unnecessary shots throughout this game.
3rd and long for him here. He's got to, and the Panthers are there to bring him down. And the defense comes through. That's going to back him up and bring up 4th down.
Pretty even match in this first half, and you're just kind of waiting, right? You just kind of try to get a feel for which defense is going to come to life. And when you get that sack, that could go a long way to infusing some energy on that side of the ball.
Torrey Taylor on to punt. And after that drive went backwards, he's going to send this one forward. And he's had a very busy game already, Brock. 3rd time they've called on him as he gets this away. The fair catch taken in at the 28-yard line. That punt goes unanswered. No return there. And it's going to be Panthers football. Offense ready to begin this drive, 1st and 10. They'll send him over right. Here's Dalton to throw. That one's incomplete. Had the connection, but some stone hands got in the way there. Deontay Johnson, the intended receiver. So it's 2nd down coming up.
Oh, that's a major missed opportunity right there. Coverage can breathe a little sigh of relief. They dodged a bullet. Time to adjust and get some extra help on the back end to take away those open shots downfield.
Tight end reels in the shallow throw, and he's downed after getting this up to the 41. They'll move the chains after that pickup of 12.
You know, it sure seems like he knew exactly where he was going with that before the snap. That's a pre-snap decision that led to a post-snap 1st down.
1st and 10 from the 41. They'll go from the gun with Sanders. And he'll come up with a gain of 3 on the run up the middle.
That's the kind of run play that feels like tug of war at field day. And you're just not moving the other side. Just a short run. Neither side feels particularly good about it. And we'll move to the next.
2nd down now, 7 to go. They send the tight end in motion. From the 43. Complete to Tremble. And he's short of the first after a mild gain.
Quarterbacks will look for their tight end short in just about any situation. They take away the deeper options. Well, there's their consistent source of positive yardage, the trusty tight end.
All plays on the table here for 3rd and 3. Throwing here, Dalton. Pass complete to Hubbard. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains.
That's what we call situational football. You spend all week working on your nickel passing game package to take advantage of 3rd downs just like that.
New set of downs for him from the 46. On the ground, Chuba Hubbard gets it. And he'll get this forward, and he's stopped at the 37. Call it 9 yards. Looked like a first for a moment. It's 2nd and 1.
Well, that doesn't net a 1st down. You get yards like that in the run game, you will take it in the NFL.
Nice spot here for the offense. It's second and one. From the 37. It's taken. The ball's out. The ball's out. He lost it. And it's a turnover. The defense has it. And they stop him before he gets much on the return.
Well, sure, you're looking to try to get a first down on second down. You're trying to create a manageable third down, but I'll tell you what you're not trying to do ever is give the ball away. And that's what the offense does to the defense right there.
Here come the Bears back out on offense. And it's not good, Brock, when you're discussing their punter as one of your early game MVPs, but they just haven't been able to get anything going so far.
No, you'll hear some old school coaches, especially defensive-minded coaches, Kate, and they'll say, hey, man, there's nothing wrong with the drive ending with a kick, right?
Mm-hmm.
As a quarterback and as an offense, maybe that was the way you played the game back in the day, but not modern football. You've got to go score.
First down. Here's Swift. And he drives that front backward on a gain of four.
He'll expect more from himself on those type of plays, but there is nobody that's going to complain about that one. If you can do math, 4 + 4 + 4 equals a first down.
Second and six coming up here. Through one quarter, neither side breaking through on the scoreboard. Couple of zeros on the board right now. Back to Soldier Field in just a moment. We're back and all set for the second quarter. Bears football. They'll have second and seven to deal with. Williams on the play action. That's into the hands of Moore. And this one's brought to a halt at about the 36-yard line. Here we go, third and less than a yard. Here's Williams. Defender arrives right as the ball does, and the hit knocks it free. Incomplete. Well, no luck on his first look of the game, so they're going to have to evaluate things now on fourth and short.
See the pass, time up your hit, and jar that ball loose. Not a lot of players are hanging on through a well-placed hit like that one.
Punter takes the field on fourth down, and he sends this one flying. Same as a touchback here. Fair catch made at the 20. No return on that punt. Man, it'll be their football. And the drive will start out with a first and 10. They send a tight end in motion. He had it for a moment, but a great defensive play to jar it loose. Incomplete.
I think everybody in the building was already thinking about the next play to run as they watched that short throw to the tight end. That's a gimme. You don't expect to see many of those dropped.
No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. Here's Dalton. Got Mingo, it's complete. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. They pick up 20 yards there, and it'll give the Panthers a first down.
And those are the completions they rely on from their passing game.
First and 10 from the 41. Hubbard quick on the draw. And this one doesn't go far. Two on the pickup there, and it's going to be second and eight.
Hey, we know running the ball in the NFL is hard, and that play pretty indicative of it. Here's the key, though. At the end of the game, those type of plays got to be in the minority, and the majority have got to do some damage.
8 yards to go. Let's see how they approach this second down. Dalton looking to throw. Nabbed by Xavier Leggett. And he's tackled after getting this to the opposing 46. 12 yards on that play, and a good call nets him the first. New set of downs for him from the 46. Now Dalton. Tight end has it across the middle. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. Give him 30 yards on that one. And that'll be good for a Carolina first.
I think my favorite part was the magic he worked after the catch. The way he took the completion and made so much more out of it by adding all the extra yardage.
Thinking touchdown here after that big play. We've got first and 10 from the red zone. Working inside the red zone. That one's incomplete in the end zone.
Just something off in the rhythm of their passing game on that one, Kate. Time to recalibrate and keep throwing it to get back on track.
So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call. Throwing now off play action. To the edge of the end zone. Oh, it's incomplete. That throw doesn't lead to six. And that's going to leave him with a tough third and long.
Just something off in the rhythm of their passing game on that one. Time to recalibrate and keep throwing it to get back into rhythm.
No connection on the last play, and out third down. A tight end in motion now. They're going to throw it on third and long. And he just gets rid of this one, but unfortunately, that means fourth down coming up.
So often, so many of these games in the NFL, well, they come down to a play or two, and third down's critical. Whether it's in a close game or already out of hand, their coach wants to see them convert those.
And it is good. No problems there on the shorter attempt. And that will get them on the board.
Well, I know once that drive stalls out, that's where it really pays to have that reliable kicker on the sideline ready to bail you out. And he knocks that one right through to give him the lead.
Now Pinheiro on to handle the kickoff. Return coming from the six. Some good work on that return. Brock gets this up to the 33. The Bears about set for their next possession. And it's far from the first time we're seeing this unit head out, Brock. But what we haven't seen so far in this opening half, well, we haven't seen much in terms of yardage.
No, it's like they've written a few lyrics, but nowhere close to a song yet.
Ball at the 33 for first down. Working from the gun, Williams. An alert play defensively there. He got a hand on it to tip it away, and that makes it second down.
I hate those situations, Kate, as a QB. I'm looking for an open passing lane, and I can't find one anywhere. He thought he had one available. Defense did a better job of knocking it away.
Couldn't connect on first. It's second down. Now an inside handoff to Swift. Breaks the tackle, green grass ahead. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. They pick up 20 yards there. And that's good for a Bears first down.
Those unsung heroes, those big guys up front on the O-line, Well, let's give them a little love right here, Kate. They don't always get the attention they deserve on a broadcast, but let me tell you, they played a huge role in that big old run.
Has his man, it's Odunze. And he's able to reach the 40 on that play. Second and three now. Williams from the gun. Moore's got it. And they bring him down around the 34. 6 yards on the play and enough for a first.
It's not just imperative that a quarterback knows man or zone. Same thing for a receiver, especially on a drag route. When he sees zone coverage like that, just settle down, find the soft spot, and give your quarterback a chance.
First down throw by Williams. Short pass caught by his tight end. And he's tackled for a short gain.
Well, that's a modest little drag route, but if you ever just need a safe short gain on a throw, that's a go-to route to target.
Second down now, 7 to go. Off the play fake, Williams. Got Everett, and it's complete. And he's tackled with the first down yardage.
When you see play action, do all you can to get your eyes to the tight end, because that's their bread and butter. That play action gives him time off the line, helps chip a rusher, or even helps sell that fake. And then when he releases, he gets out, he gets some leverage, he gets to that edge before the defender can cover him.
He's got it, room to run. And he works this to the 15 before they make the stop.
Oh man, these are the kind of plays you can't wait to get on film and watch the next day. Look at the fellow pass catchers. Look at the guys getting out in front, helping on that screen pass. Get your player in space, your buddies do the rest around you, and a big play follows.
After a good pickup, they're set up with second and short. Running behind center with Swift. And he's dropped just short of the marker, maybe a yard away. So we're at the 2-minute warning here from Soldier Field. The Bears at a disadvantage on the scoreboard. Third down, 1 yard to go. Out of the gun, here's Williams. Complete beyond the marker. And he'll pick up enough to move the chains. Now after making that catch, we see he's shaken up. Trainers heading out to take a look. They'll break the huddle and come up on first and goal. Throwing from the gun. This one's caught. And he'll score. Touchdown, Chicago! The Bears get some late points and the lead. It's a Keenan Allen touchdown. That is a touchdown to one of their prime receiving targets.
This is really what you pay your skill guys for. You know, I had an old coordinator say, it's my job to get you a one-on-one. It's your job to go out and win it with a touchdown.
Now Cairo Santos on to add the PAT. That one right down the middle. And they'll continue adding to their lead. Taylor has it on the tee and is ready to send and fly. Starting from the 5. He's brought down at what looks like the 24-yard line. Carolina about set to go once again offensively. And they settled for a field goal on their last series, so points are a positive, but they'll look to upgrade to a touchdown here. They'll get this drive started. First and 10. To throw, here's Dalton. That one falls to the turf, couldn't hang on, it's incomplete. He was looking Xavier Leggett's way there. And that'll bring up second down.
That drop ruins the payoff to a well-designed play. It got a man open, it beat the coverage. That's a call they can revisit in the future with hopefully a much better job finishing the catch.
Second and 10 now. That's more of the catch out left. And a nice gain here, but it stopped short of the first.
The goal of running that drag route is to get it to him for at least a minimal gain with space to add after that. It picked up a good chunk, and there was nearly room to add even more.
Panthers moving quickly, trying to get set at the line. Throwing now, third and 2. He'll dump this one off to his running back, complete. And he'll get it up near the 38-yard line before going down. Now after making that catch, we see he's shaken up. Trainers heading out to take a look. New set of downs for him at the 38. Still sticking with the passing game. Catch is made down the right sideline. And they bring him down around the 34. He'll move the sticks after ripping off a gain of 28.
Well, that's a gain that has its roots in preparation during the week. That's Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday kind of stuff. Identifying ways to target the coverage and creating opportunities for big completions.
Here's first and 10 from the 34. Dalton. It's taken in by Mingo. And he's down inside the red zone before hitting the deck. Now Carolina's going to take a timeout. That's its second. And they still have one in their pocket for what's left of this half. They'll keep this drive moving and come to the line for first and 10. From the red zone now. That's knocked away by a defender, incomplete. That one doesn't make it beyond the line. And we'll see what they do here on second down.
Well, that throw, Kate, pretty clean out of his hand. Just looked like it didn't get through the defense clean enough. Somebody tips it away and saves a potential completion.
They are throwing it again. This is reeled in by Leggett. And it's good yardage, but they tackle him short of the sticks. Panthers moving quickly, trying to get set at the line. And oh, he got it! Interception! Jalen Johnson with the pick.
I know exactly what the quarterback was envisioning when he let that one go. Touchdown, baby. Not long after, I know exactly what he was thinking. Oh, no! Give me that one back. Because the coverage baited him perfectly into that throw, and even more so, picked it off.
Only 10 seconds remaining here, so first and 10 may be our last snap of the half. All right, keeping it simple. They're just going to call a give right up the middle. And he'll take it up to the 30 before being brought down. So at halftime, it's the Bears out in front in Chicago. Now we'll send you south to Orlando for a check-in around the league via Jonathan Coachman and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, what you got for us?
All right, Kate, thanks very much. We'll let you and Brock catch your breath as we welcome the rest of you to our EA Sports Halftime Report. In the first half, it was the rookie from USC, Caleb Williams, who was looking the part. He has a touchdown pass, and that amounted to the only touchdown of the game for either team thus far.
As always, a hat tip to Coach for his hard work during the break, as we're happy to welcome y'all back for the start of our third quarter. Taylor has it on the tee and is ready to send and fly. Raheem Blackshear now to return. And this drive will start inside the 25. Carolina ready to get things started on offense to begin the third. And their defense sure has kept this game close. Now it's time for them to come through, get some points for their team in this low-scoring affair. Drive starts out with a first and 10. Trying to shake off the interception. He's looking to throw. Gets this to Johnson. And he's going to be out of bounds just before reaching the 30.
Now here's a spot where the timing's got to be absolutely perfect, Kate, between the quarterback and the receiver. That throw is made before that receiver's ever thinking of coming out of his cut. Too early, it's incomplete. Too late, and it's headed the other way.
From the 28. Tight end reels in the shallow throw. And they're going to bring him down just beyond the 30 at the 31.
This defense didn't give up contain there, Kate. That was an instance where the more exciting plays were taken away downfield. And even looking to the tight end wasn't going to net them much.
All plays on the table here for third and 3. Trying the inside handoff to Sanders. And he's going to get this up to the 45 before he's brought down. Big gain, 14 on the play. And it'll give the Panthers a first down.
That right there, that will make the coaches happy. He didn't just get the first down, but got a healthy chunk of bonus yards afterwards.
Ball on the 45, first and 10. Sending a receiver left. Now Dalton. Nothing there left side as it ends up incomplete. This one misses the tight end. And now it's second down.
There's the importance of staying in phase as a defender. He was all over him in coverage. And that really did help force the incompletion.
No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. Here's Sanders. And he's caught behind the line for a loss.
Well, they were hoping. They were hoping to get outside and meet those guys at the second level. Well, someone from the second level came to beat him on his turf. And that meeting didn't go so well.
He's driving some serious trouble. It's third and 12. Slot receiver headed left. They're going to throw it on third and long. That's complete to Leggett. And they push this down to the opposing 47-yard line.
Pursue, pursue, pursue. It's why they do these drills all the time, Kate. You do them through the offseason, you do them through training camp, you do them in the regular season. Because when a defense plays with tremendous pursuit, you force fourth downs just as they did.
Punt team is on now, and they get this away. And this one ventures out of play on the fly. The question is where it's marked. Looks like they'll say the 17-yard line. The Bears and DeAndre Swift set for their next drive. And it has been all about these defenses so far, Brock. Even into the second half, we're still waiting for one of these offenses to take charge.
Yeah, what you're feeling, these defenses are making every yard tough, every first down tough, every series tough. And offensively, yeah, it's time to toughen up and maybe more importantly, sharpen up.
First down, Williams. Catch made by Carter. And they take him down at the 24-yard line.
That is a textbook first down completion. Sets up second and very manageable and creates space to take that shot downfield.
Second and three now. Running with Swift out of the gun. Jukes one defender. And that's good yardage with a new set of downs.
You know, coach gets in that QB's headset, probably told his offense and his QB, listen, I don't want to see a third down on this possession. Or something kind of like that. Whatever version he told him, it worked.
New set of downs for him at the 38. Williams to throw on first. He lets a heater go deep, middle of the challenges, double coverage, and it's intercepted. J.C. Horn to pick it off. And the Panthers return the interception almost to midfield before the tackle's made. Well, they left the locker room in front. Great position to be in, right? But a shaky start to half number two with that interception.
We know that no lead in the NFL is safe. A one-point lead, something that looks insurmountable. How many of these games so often come down to one possession in the end? With a half of football left, you just can't give away too many gifts and too many possessions.
So good field position for the Panthers. Starting this drive, first and 10. Sanders on the shotgun handoff. And he'll cross the 50 and start pushing onto the opposing side of the field. Give him around six. That's going to make it second and four.
I'm not kidding you, Kate. A run of that length at the NFL level, honestly, is the equivalent of a run of 15-plus at the high school level. It's hard in the run game to make yards, and they just got a very successful one.
Here's Sanders once more. And he takes it just inside the 40, down to the 39. That one ends up a gain of six. And that'll be good for a Carolina first.
Well, looky here. You don't even have to worry now about a third down call as that run moves the sticks. Now that call you had ready, though, you can recycle it. Save it for later for that next third down coming.
Here's Dalton to throw. This one is hit by a defender and winds up incomplete. Broken up by a big guy at the line. So it'll be second down.
Well, the QB right there, he put it pretty close to the sidelines to begin with. And the defender, well, that was a nice job. Just simply put a hand out there and let me just encourage the ball to fall incomplete.
Throwing here, Dalton. He finds Johnson. And he'll get this down at the 33-yard line.
The goal of that little drag route is to get him for at least a minimal gain with space to add after that. That picked up a good chunk, and it was nearly a big play.
Chance to move the chains here on third and four. Dalton looking to throw. And it's incomplete, and that's going to bring up fourth down.
You know, it's a point of emphasis in practice each and every week, no matter where we go. How are we going to attack the coverage on third down? We chose the wrong play off that call sheet that time.
Staring at fourth down now, the Panthers electing to go with Eddie Pinheiro for the field goal try. This is a 50-yard look from the right hash. And this kick is good. He needed to get all of it there, and he did. And that cuts the lead back down to a lone point.
A lot of them may make it look automatic, but you get this deep, then those field goals are far from a certainty. It took all his concentration, every bit of his strength, to send that puppy through.
Things trim back down to a single point prop as they send this off and away. That's going to be taken in at the 8. Finds some space. He's past the 30. Tackle made as the return gets it out to the 32. The Bears and this running back headed back out for a new series. They are coming off their first interception of the game. This drive now a chance to rebuild some confidence. It's a new set of downs for him at the 32. Off the play fake, Williams. Allen on the catch. And he flips the field for them before being taken down.
One thing we don't have in football is we don't have that radar gun. But if we did, Kate, this is the kind to throw. When you throw it that deep outside the numbers, that requires a serious fastball, serious arm strength, and he just showed it off.
Four downs now to get in. Here's first and goal. Working inside the red zone. And he'll score. Touchdown, Chicago! The Bears grow the lead to 7. He hung in there as long as he could. A lot of quarterbacks would have bailed out. And it was what you talk about, Brock. That courage that kept the chance for the touchdown alive.
Yeah, that touchdown's going to show up on his stat sheet making the catch or the quarterback stat sheet for making the throw. But, hey, can we put some touchdowns up there for the big boys up front? It was their blocking and buying of time for that play that led to the score.
Santos now for the extra point. That one splits the uprights. And they'll continue adding to their lead. Taylor has it on the tee and is ready to send and fly. This one's fielded at the 40-yard line. And he's brought down just inside the 25 on the return. The Panthers and Andy Dalton headed back onto the field. And on that last drive, Brock, he crossed a notable threshold in passing yards for the season. Always nice when you can reach one of those plateaus to look back on after the year is over. They're out and set, first and 10. One of the tight ends in motion left. Dalton now to throw. Gets this to Sanders. And he's brought down after a nice gain and a first down.
Kate, I can promise you, you go back and look at the most efficient offenses in the NFL over the last couple decades, one thing will resonate. You've got to be able to attack the middle of the field. It's great to do it with receivers. It's awesome with tight ends. But when you get that influence from your running backs, man, you become a dangerous offense to stop.
Sanders running dead ahead. And he's brought down by a collective effort there. Only 1 yard on the carry.
Okay, this is why you got to be careful to just run it always on first down. You got to break your tendencies. The casual fan... Well, that casual fan knew what was coming, but more importantly, this defensive front did too.
They'll come to the line here, 2nd and 9. Here's Dalton. The Bears close it in, and they'll get him. And that pushes him back, 3rd down coming up.
Kate, I've seen a one-step drop. I've seen a 3, a 5, a 7. Some of the boots and play actions get more depth. But a 20-step drop? That's not going to cut it. Except for this defense, it just adds a whole bunch of negative yards to that play.
Defense looking to defend the marker on third down. To throw, here's Dalton. Complete to Tremble. And they push this down to the opposing 47-yard line. So a timely moment for a big play, and they get the first on third and 19.
I'm not sure how this defense let that guy slip through him like that. On third down, nonetheless, he took that snap as an opportunity, and man, did he make an impact play.
Mingo, the motion man here. So we're through three here. The Panthers have it to start, coming in trailing on the scoreboard. Football on that 47-yard line, first down. Off the play fake, he'll throw. And this one's dropped for what would have been a nice game. He was looking Xavier Leggett's way there. And it sets up second down.
Oh, that drop is such a bummer because it ruins the payoff of such a well-designed play, Kate. Got the man open, beat the coverage. Then you got to go finish it. You got to go make that catch. I will say, keep that one in mind. They could revisit that play in the future.
And he won't escape. The Bears take him down. And that pushes him back. Third down coming up.
Kate, this is one of those times and moments that even though it's been years and decades, I could still hear the great Mike Holmgren saying to me, after I tried to scramble as a QB that couldn't really run like our guy today, and he would say, oh, Brock, bless your heart. Oh, bless your heart. And really what he's saying is don't ever try that again.
The Bears into the nickel for third down. Back to throw. To him again. And consecutive sacks have them staring at a tough fourth down.
Some squads you just see love to do this, Kate, and I've got so much respect for defensive coordinators who late in the game, instead of playing prevent, well, they step up the aggression meter. Back-to-back sacks puts this offense and this quarterback way off schedule.
Carolina in punt formation. Johnny Hecker, the one to send it away. And he sends this away. Definitely his best kick of the game thus far. And the fair catch secure here at the 16. We don't get a return out of that punt. And it's going to be Bears football. The Bears offense now heads back out to the field. They really had the passing game clicking on that last touchdown drive, partner. We'll see if they stick with that or if they mix things up a bit on this series. Offense ready to begin this drive, first and 10. Williams set to pass. Finds his target, Allen. And he's gonna get this up to the 26 before being taken down. Nice spot here for the offense, it's second and one. The shotgun to give to Swift, and he's dropped just short of the marker, maybe a yard away.
An offensive group really hoped he was going to get it all right there, reset it back to first down, but instead the defense, well, they're not going to let anything come easy, and their fight has given them a chance to stall things out on a third and short.
On third down, here's Swift. Bring him down just beyond the 30 at the 31. It's a gain of four there, and that's a Chicago first down.
He easily had the yardage for a first, but he was hungry for a lot more. I think that tackle prevented something that was going to be a lot bigger than just a first down pickup.
First down throw by Williams. Komet brings it in. And he'll cover up as they touch him down a few yards short of the first. Second and three now. On the ground with Swift. And he's going to be brought down at the 42. It's a four-yard gain, and that's going to get him across the marker and earn the first.
I don't know about you, Kate, but he sure made getting that first down look really easy. A lot easier than it's supposed to be for that defense. And I think they'll hear about it when they get to the sidelines.
They'll head up first and 10 from the 42. This one delivered off target, Brock. That's incomplete.
That just goes to show you can't take any completion for granted, even on some of the shortest passes in the game plan.
So after the incompletion, here comes the second down call. Working from the gun, Williams. Short pass caught by his tight end. It's third and eight. Need to get a chunk here. Williams from the gun. He's going to try to drop it in deep right. That one is incomplete. Couldn't hang on through the contact. Roma Dunze, the intended receiver. And that brings up fourth and long.
Defender's not going to be thrilled. The catch was almost made on his watch, but more importantly, he breaks it up. Gives him a chance to do a little jawing after the play. Let's the other guy know he roughed him up and cost him that catch.
Fourth down and on comes the punt team and the kick's away. That hits at the nine, but nobody around to grab it. It carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. The Carolina offense headed out now. And as much as we thought we'd be watching highlights here, talking about this passing game, Brock, it's been the guys on the other side of the ball who've come in and stolen that spotlight.
Yeah, and in an offensive-driven league, and one that's sometimes even legislated that way, it's nice, refreshing to see a defense put together an effort like this.
Amen.
Be the ones everybody's talking about for how well they've played on their side of the ball.
And the drive will start out with a first and 10. They'll begin with a quick completion to the right side. Give them 11 yards, Brock, and a fresh set of downs.
The smartest pass catchers I've ever been around, they know how to set up an out cut beautifully. They recognize when they have leverage, how to sell the deep route, and then boom, they just break it out as if it's nothing.
They've got first down from the 31. Dalton. Well, the pressure nearly got to him, but still a good play defensively as that one falls incomplete.
Well, that's one you chalk up to the pressure earning that incompletion. They came in before he could find a target, hit him, altered that last second attempt to get rid of it.
Couldn't connect on first. It's second down. Throwing from the gun here. Got Mingo. It's complete. And they're going to touch him down after a short pickup. Third and six for them to figure out now. He'll throw it. That's caught for the first. And they finally bring him down, but that is a big gain and a new set of downs. He'll move the sticks after ripping off a gain of 28.
You know, they call that the money down for a reason, because you're just simply not going to last long in the NFL if you don't convert a good portion of your third downs. It's the money down, and nice to see them roll the dice and continue the series.
Markers reset, ball at the 37. They send a receiver in motion right. They are throwing it again. finds Sanders. And he's tackled after gaining a handful.
These intermediate gains, that's the wheelhouse for these two to connect on. Start the series off well. And it sure keeps a defense on its toes in case they try to load up and just simply cover the receivers.
After a good pickup, they've got second and four. Out of the shotgun, a give to Hubbard. And he's dropped just short of the marker, maybe a yard away. And the Bears bring in an extra defensive back for this third down. Back to throw it. Complete beyond the marker. And he'll get it down to the 24-yard line. It's a gain of four. And it'll give the Panthers a first down. It's the two-minute warning from Chicago. Panthers trail by eight. Up to the line, and they're set. First and 10. Now Dalton. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. He was looking Xavier Leggett's way there. So second down coming up.
Can't cover it much better than that really well-covered gate on that play. There just simply was not a window for him to sneak that throw in.
No dice on that prior pass. Here's second down. Looking to throw it. He's got it near the eight. And they catch up to him, but not until he's got a huge gain and a first down. The middle, Hubbard, and he pushed for it, but they managed to stop him at the 2-3 yards on the gain. Now they just need two more on second and goal.
Okay, all right, there's a little progress on first and goal. You keep it safe, you push a little closer, and now you're set up for what you want to do on second down.
Trying it again with Hubbard. And they take it across the goal line for a Carolina touchdown. The Panthers cut it to just two late in the game. Chuba Hubbard with the touchdown. So there's part one, Brock. They get the touchdown that they desperately needed. Now you'd imagine comes a try for two.
Yeah, and this might be just as tough as to go get that touchdown they just did because, well, they work on two-point conversions, but they're difficult. This is also a must-have, though, Kate, if they want to try and force overtime.
So now here come the Panthers' big moments as they go for two. And he's taken down. The defense maintains the two-point lead. That was the play they needed. Now gotta hope your defense or special teams can come through and get you that football back.
And the sooner the better, too, because time is not their friend. They always have the onside kick to bail them out. But after that, it might be time for this D coordinator to crank up the aggression meter. And you know every one of these defenders will be attacking the ball.
We're down inside the final 90 seconds as they line up for the all-important onside kick. And it looks like the Bears are able to recover that kick. And they'll get him down after he gets into the 48. Ooh, can't get it back on the onside kick. Can still get a final chance with a quick three and out, though, albeit not with a lot of time for them left to work with.
Yeah, Kate, unless they can force a miracle turnover, and we've seen that before, a three and out is really the only avenue remaining. Defense, go buckle it up.
Chicago's offense trotting out there for another series. And that two-point lead, it's still right there on the scoreboard, Brock, after their defense got off the field clean.
And now, Kate, this offensive goal is to make sure that clock expires with that lead still in hand and them holding the ball. You absolutely do not want to give this ball back, knowing the other side still just needs a field goal.
And he winds up with a solid gain down past the 45. Now Carolina's going to take a timeout. That's its second, as they'll meet and decide what to do on this second down. Going run again with Swift. And they'll get there and stop him at the line. Now the Panthers decide to spend their third and final timeout. And they'll take a moment to ponder what the call's going to be on third down. Looking to throw. Got a man over the middle, complete. And they make the stop. We're going to say it about the 37-yard line. 5 yards on that play and enough for a new set of downs.
You're not going to last long in the National Football League if you don't convert a good chunk of your third downs. Nice find there to continue the series.
And he's going to take a knee.
Nothing left to do now, Kate, but celebrate on one side and watch on hopelessly from the other. What a hard-fought effort to get to this spot. And now you can enjoy the victory.
A kneel down here, and they can start to celebrate this win. So the Bears come away with a win. This is the type of game everyone was hoping they'd see when they entered this stadium, Brock, you and I included. A close one that went all the way down to the final whistle.
And Kay, this is one of the bigger adjustments a college player has to make to the NFL. In college, you get a lot of blowouts. The NFL, every game you get calloused because you know more often than not, they'll be like this, a one-possession game that's not about how you start. It's all about how you finish.
So for Brock Heward and all of our crew, I'm Kate Scott, wrapping up another edition of the NFL on EA Sports. The Bears winners, as we say so long from Chicago.